Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create ROI in Excel sheet and different factors required to calculate ROI in any specific RPA projects. At the end of this video, I will give you 5 pillar points which is required to calculate ROI of any specific RPA project. So if you have not yet subscribed this channel, consider subscribing. So whenever I will upload any of the video, you will get to notified about the new content available on my channel. And don't forget to hit like and pressing bell icon for more updates. When we are talking about how to calculate ROI for RPA projects, it's very important for the organization who has invested the dollars or rupees in any specific RPA projects. They want to move the complete resources into the digital transformations. So because of that, they have invested it. So it's very important on their point of view to remember that there is a more than one way to look at how RPA benefits a business. There is the financial benefits, of course, but there are also more intangible benefits such as employees, moral or vendor relationship management. Return on investment, what is the actual cost of implementation is the first questions raised on any investors who has invested their money into the RPA project. Because RPA software is tailored to each individual business that uses it, there isn't a one size fits that all answers to how much the software will cost. It should be noted that RPA is relatively inexpensive compared to some other software such as services, that is SaaS software. Because RPA software is designed to focus on the type of task we looked at earlier, it integrates fairly easily into the existing architectures. So here we have several points which we are considering here, like cutting cost. While many companies have capable IT workers contracting experts in RPA software design and implementations, can save on cost. An in-house IT specialist will need to take the time to learn how to design a scalable RPA system, design the processes and implement it. While that may seem like it would cost less, that means you are specialized will be foregoing their other duties for an unextended period of time. But bringing in experts from outside your company, or you have to streamline the process and save the time and money. RPA maintenance cost is very much important factor. Another cost of investment is the cost of maintenance, much like the cost of software development. This cost is usually quite reasonable. This is because of RPA software is developed in-house. You have already budgeted for his cost. After all, you already employ the people who will perform the maintenance. Benefit of investing in RPA is majorly minimizing the effort, time, and getting the accuracies. So let's discuss what all 5 pillars we have when we are considering RPA ROIs. So first pillar is efficiency. So if you have built any solution or bot, how much efficient it is, it really going to give you a benefit out of it? And is it really giving you accuracy in terms of providing solutions or execution in point of production activities? Is it really saving you time and cost and money? So, which is very important when we talk about the efficiency. Without that, it's not at all possible when you are working on any specific RPA projects. Second point is cost avoidance. Have you saved anything from there? Have you saved in resources? Have you saved on the regular cost of your FTE employees? Or have you saved time in terms of hiring the resources, in terms of different teams management? So if you have not yet considered each and everything, maybe you can go to the procurement team and find out the actual cost of hiring the resources, actual cost of deploying services or the getting systems or getting servers in your environment, which is a very important part. So because of that, it's called as cost avoidance is very much important when we are considering any specific RPA projects. Third point is risk avoidance. So when the solution is ready, you have to check this point, risk avoidance is available or not. And what all factors you can remove it when you are designing any bot solutions or you are moving into the production activities. Then fourth point is your accuracy. How much secure are the data you have built the solutions? Is it related to your accuracy is providing 100% or more than 99%? Without that, this factor, it's not going to be time RPA or a time bot delivered or created for you. Accuracy is definitely going to help you when you will execute in the production activities. Let's say if you are working on any banking systems and you want to track their detail or transaction details on the regular basis. So if you have missed anything, it means you are not providing the accurate content to the end user. So without that, none of the bot or none of the solutions are calculated on in terms of ROI. Then finally, audit. How much time it is taking to the doing the auditing or verifying your content on the server, and whatever bot has built, is it right enough or your data is accurate or not, what we are getting perfectly. There are several other examples are available just now here. Considering one bank related app example, because here I want to cover only the ROI part of the RPA project. So when we are considering all of the five pillars, it is very much important you have to take care of each and everything. And RPA cost estimations or RPA ROI is never being calculated for the small projects, or this is not going to help you when you are working on the small project. When you have 4 or 5 years of project in development, that time you will get actual or the maximum benefit out of these type of RPA projects. So let's see in this Excel, you'll find it on number of business processes the RPA bot will automate. Here you will see two. How many FTEs currently work on that task? There are four. What percentage of FTE daily time is spent on the task? 50% of the time they are spending the task to do this activity. What is the average fully loaded salary of the FTE performing that task? So it means we are providing $50,000 for four employees. It means somewhere around $12,500 per FTE resources. Estimated cost per bot implementation is $30,000. It means we are saving $20,000 for any year or whatever the duration it is calculated for the $50,000. So estimated maintenance is $10,000. It means again we are saving $10,000. So when we talk about the first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, and sixth year, or all of the above, you will find it out less saving in terms of first year. That's why I said when we are working on the large duration project, then only we will get sure ROI of our RPA projects. Otherwise, you will get less return in terms of your investment. Second year, you will find it out 128% annual accrued ROI. 128%. It means higher than more than 100%. Now, third year, you have seen 200%, fourth year, 500%, fifth year, 300%. So these all are factors which we can include: current cost of FTE, hours per week of FTE, cost per week of FTE. These all are calculated. Then the total annual cost for bot implementation per year, maintenance of second year onwards. So you can see first year, it took $60,000 for implementing these bot. But from next year onwards, it will take only $10,000 for the maintenance activity. We don't need to create these solutions again and again. But when we are doing this activity on the resource basis, on the manual basis, you can find it out. Same cost is occurring again and again. But this is a considering on the same fluctuation level, but we do have to cover, or we do have to consider their salary hike as well. Or if we are hiring the other resources, then we have to consider the cost of the hiring person as well. So you can see this is not at all seen for the all of the year. Definitely it is going to be increased, but here we have considered only seen for all 5 years. But none of the resource can stay in the same salary package on every year. Even on the cost of the services or cost of the tools is also going to be increased. because of that, I'm saying, but if we are considering seeing for all 4 or 5 years, then also we have saved your $70,000 second year, $70,000 third year, then net ROI $70,000. And the current cost of FTE is $80,000. Again, we have saved 255.56% in the fourth year. And fifth year, we have saved $70,000 on net ROI. It means we are saving on the regular basis. So this is how we are calculating ROI or providing the figures to the end user. So that's all about calculating ROI in any RPA projects. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed the session or you think there are some additional changes will be required in this Excel sheet, then definitely you can comment in the comment section so that this will help the other user who is watching this. Thank you for watching.